Today we're going to be doing a disk and washer method problem. And in this particular example, we've been asked to find the area of the region bounded by y equals 1 minus x squared and y equals 0 when that region is revolved around the y-axis. So with these disk and washer method problems, the first thing I like to do is draw a picture if I can. And sometimes that can be harder than other times depending on the curves that you're dealing with. In this case, it's not too difficult because 1 minus x squared and 0, y equals 0, are not difficult functions to graph. So let's go ahead and draw a picture of what we've got going on here. Here's our y-axis. Here's our x-axis. And if we go ahead and draw a picture of these two curves, we'll call this one here y equals 1 minus x squared. We'll do that in orange. If we say that this is 1 along the y-axis and this is 1 along the x-axis, a picture of y equals 1 minus x squared of the graph would look like this, right? It's an upside down parabola, or a parabola that points down like this. So that's a picture of that one. And then if we call y equals 0 in green, obviously that's easy. That's just right along the x-axis here in green. So as you can see, we know that we're going to rotate around the y-axis. So we're going to do a rotation like that. And we have this region here that's bounded by these two curves. What we're going to do, because we're asked to rotate around the y-axis, we're going to take a cross-section that's perpendicular to the y-axis. So you can almost imagine a cross-section of this, you know, being a little rectangular piece of our curve like that. And basically, when we revolve this around the y-axis, what we're looking at is half of a sphere, right, that's sitting on top of the x-axis. So it's almost, if we drew it out in 3D, it would look like this, with the y-axis coming here and the x-axis coming here, and it's sitting right on top of the x-axis. When we rotate it around, we're just going to get a little sliver of this half sphere, and we're going to find the area based on that kind of image. So because we're rotating around the y-axis, one of the first things we're going to need to do is make sure that we solve both of our functions in terms of x if we can. So currently we have two functions that are, sorry, not in terms of x, for x. We need to solve both of them for x. So we have y equals something for both of our functions. We need to change them both into x equals something if possible. So instead of y equals 1 minus x squared, let's go ahead and add x squared to both sides. We'll get x squared plus y equals 1. And then again, we want to solve for x, so we'll go ahead and subtract y from both sides and get x squared equals 1 minus y. And then to solve for x, we'll take the square root of both sides and we'll get x equals the square root of 1 minus y. So that's our first function. Our second function, y equals 0, we can't solve in terms of x, right? Because it's just a horizontal line. So there's nothing we can do about that, but it doesn't really matter because we know that our limits of integration are going to be 0 and 1, right? Normally when we rotate around the x-axis, which is what we do more commonly, we're looking at limits of integration like this, right? From 0 to 1, something like that. But because we're rotating around the y-axis, we're going to be looking at limits of integration along the y-axis. So the first one being 0, and the second one here being 1, right, along the y-axis. So we know our limits of integration. We have our functions in terms of x. We know when we're talking disk washer method here that there is no washer, right? This is just going to be a disk because we have this line here, right, along the x-axis, y equals 0, and we're rotating around the y-axis. There's not going to be a hole here in the middle, right? There's no hole. If we were integrating from, let's call it 1/2 right here, from 1, and let's do that in a different color. If we were integrating from 1/2 to 1, we would have a hole that would look like this here in the middle. But because we're integrating from 0 to 1, there is no hole in the graph. So there's no washer, it's just a disk. So that means our limits of integration are 0 and 1. So we can start putting together our formula for the volume of this rotation, this rotated region. So we know our limits of integration are from 0 to 1 along the y-axis. We know that our outer function is this orange function here. We've solved for it in terms of x, so we're actually going to use this one down here, x equals the square root of 1 minus y squared. Recall that the formula for a rotated region like this is volume equals limits of integration from a to b, pi times the outer curve, essentially, squared, minus pi times the inner curve squared dx if you're rotating around the x-axis. In our case, we're going to have pi, that's part of our formula. Our outer curve is going to be the square root of 1 minus y that we solved for. Square that. And because there's no washer here, because there's nothing to subtract here, there's no hole, we can leave this part out. And then instead of dx, because we're rotating around the y-axis, we're going to call this dy. So in terms of y, and we're going to integrate with respect to y. So now this becomes fairly easy. We're just going to simplify the integral as much as possible before we integrate. The square of the square root of 1 minus y is just 1 minus y dy. We can pull pi out in front of the integral since it's a constant, and it's a coefficient here on this y minus 1 term. So we end up with just 1 minus y. And then when we integrate, v equals pi, the integral of 1 with respect to y is simply y. The integral of negative y here is negative 1 half y squared. And then we're going to be evaluating on the range 0 to 1. So now we can just go ahead and first plug in 1. So we'll get 1 minus 1 half times 1 squared is just going to give us 1 half. Then we have to subtract and plug in our lower limits of integration. Our lower limit of integration is 0, so we'll get 0 minus 1 half times 0 squared is still 0. So now that we've plugged in our limits of integration, the zeros are going to go away. We'll be left with 1 minus 1 half, which is 1 half. And when we simplify that, we'll simply get 1 half pi, or we can call it pi over 2. And that is the volume of this region rotated around the y-axis. So again, the volume bounded by the x-axis here, or the function y equals 0, and this curve here rotated around the x-axis, the volume of that region is pi over 2. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.